Hey, how you guys doing? My name is Kennedy James. I'm going to be assisting my client through a power phase workout that is going to include some movement prep, core balance, plyo, some dynamic stretches, resistance. So we're going to start off right now with a warm-up. So my client also has upper syndrome distortion, so we're going to hit the upper trap with a SMR using basically like a little small pressure point object so that we can get deep into that muscle, which is that back trapezius muscle. All right, so here we go. All right, so right now I've already got my client laying down. So I've instructed him to try to find the tender spot right behind his trapezius muscle, and we're gonna hold that tension for about 30 seconds. All right, so go ahead and count it right now. We got a clock right up there, so that'll help us out. So basically what you wanna do is you already found the tender spot, right? So, and once you found that tender spot, and that's where you wanna, you know, just kinda lay and have that pressure on. So you can also adjust your arms a little bit, bring it out to the side to see if that helps to put a little bit more pressure on that trapezius muscle. All right, that's 30 seconds. Now go ahead and switch it over to the other side. All right, and just kind of move around until you find that part where it's the most tender, and then once you get there, let me know.
Okay.
All right, you're right there. All right, so we're starting the clock right now. You got 30 seconds. And like I said, if you need to, you can also move that arm around just to see if it increases that pressure on that particular muscle.
Yeah, I can definitely feel that.
We got 5 seconds. 3, 2, 1. All right, now go ahead and stand up for me. And so what we're gonna also do is basically a static stretch also for your upper trapezius muscle, all right? So the static stretch also, once we do it, we're gonna hold it for a 30 count, all right? So basically what I would like for you to do is you're gonna come down, right? You're gonna put your chin to your chest, and then you're gonna tilt over to your left. You're gonna take your left hand, you're gonna just grab your head without pulling it too much, and then turn your head upward, all right? So. So we'll start with a 30 count. Go ahead and turn your head a little bit more. All right, now stop and relax. All right, now once again, I want you to put your chin down. And now we're gonna do the other side. All right, so take your right hand and go ahead and guide it over there. And then slightly tilt your chin up this way. We're gonna do that also.
Better.
We got about 5 seconds left. 3, 2, 1. All right. All right. Now we're going to go into our dynamic warm up. All right. So we've got a couple of objects out here set up so that we can do our dynamic warm up. The first thing that's on the on our list is going to be medicine ball rotation. All right. So what I would like for you to do is, can you hold this for me? So you're gonna simply hold this medicine ball, Make sure you got your feet out, just shoulder width apart. Extend your arms out, and you're just gonna rotate. And I want you to do that 10 on each side, all right? All right, feet shoulder width apart, arms extended out as far as you can, and then try to lock the elbows, and then just rotate nice with a nice slow tempo, and count each one. That's one. Two, and then try not to lean back too much. Make sure you're engaging your core, you draw in your navel. That'll help to also stabilize up your lower back. How many are you on?
I believe that's four right there.
Warm up basically with this type of a dynamic stretch, right? You're activating these muscles so that once we start getting into the routine, good. All right, okay. All right, next up is we're gonna have a lunge with rotation, right? So again, you're fine right there. So again, what you're gonna do is you're gonna lunge, make sure you're under control, and then you're gonna rotate. Push back up, and then do the other leg. Rotate, push back up, all right? And then you're gonna do 10 on each side as well too. Step up just a little bit. There you go, right there. Okay. See if you can step out just a little bit further. So it should be in here.
Okay.
Right? Lunge. And excuse me, yeah. So you're gonna lunge, bring it out, you're gonna rotate, and then come back in. And you can bring it in once you come back up. And then lunge again. And then rotate. Okay, push back up. And then in. And then next leg, push out. So what I would like for you to do is, as you are coming down, you're extending at the same time.
Okay.
And then rotate, and then back, and then bring it back in. Okay. Oh, nice one, motion, good. Out, rotate, back in. You can take your time with it. Next up, we're going to use the medicine ball, stability ball, with the med ball. Hold that for me for a second. So basically what I would like for you to do, this is called the Russian twist. All right. Make sure you get yourself nice and balanced on the stability ball. Make sure your feet are wide apart like this. And And all you wanna do is from here, is to twist. Now make sure you're engaging your core so that you don't slip off the ball. And just go from side to side. Right? To the left, front, to the right, front. And you're gonna do 10 on each side, all right? Sorry about the stability ball, it's a little flat, but that's all we have. All right, so first you wanna go ahead and sit on the ball. Okay. All right? And then now rope, and then now extend yourself out. Come out a little bit more. And then just make sure, and then now I want you to bring your pelvic, and I want you to thrust it up. Okay. All right? And I wanna make sure as you rotate, right, you're not slipping, so make sure you're engaging your core. All right, and then now I want you to go and you can slide to side. Okay. To the left, up, and then to the right. It's one. Two. It's three. You just slowly just roll yourself back up. Take the ball from you. All right, cool. All right, next up, we have what are called leg swings. You're gonna do front to back and side to side. So let me demonstrate for you. So we'll just use this mirror as a brace. So just put your left hand up against the mirror, and all you're gonna do is just gonna swing your leg front to back, front to back. And I want you to do 10 each way. All right, so the 1, 2, 3. All right, and do 10 on each side. Try to extend as far back as you can and as far up as you can. Yep. Once you get to 10, then I want you to switch sides and do it for your left leg. And our last dynamic stretch is going to be a push-up with rotation. All right, so let me demonstrate for you. So make sure you get a nice base. All right, make sure your hands are about shoulder width apart. Are you gonna go down? When you come up, you're just gonna rotate up. All right, down, up, and rotate up. I want you to do 10 on each side as well. Okay. That's one. Thank you. chest cavity. Looks great. So how do you feel so far?
Good.
I'm starting to work up sweat already.
That's good.
So basically what we just did right there was your dynamic warm-up. And the reason why we're doing a dynamic warm-up is because you are in a phase five, which is the power phase. So normally if you were like maybe in a phase two, three, or four, we would do, you know, maybe some active ISO or some statics. But because you are in the power phase, that's the reason why we're doing a dynamic warm-up. So basically get the blood flowing. Get the joints, you know, moving nice. You know, you got a little bit more flexibility. So now we're about to get into our next phase of the exercise. Is going to be the movement prep, core balance, plyometrics.
All right. So we're moving back into our movement prep, core balance, and plyo. So right now I've got the exercises ready. The first one is going to be a medicine ball slam, right? So you're going to take it, you're going to go, and just slam it as hard as you can, and then repeat that cycle for 10, right? Once you're done with that, you're going to move over to the proprioceptor plyometrics, all right? So you're just going to get in there and go back and forth for 10. Once you go back and forth, then you're going to do side to side, 1, 2, 3, four, and then once you're done with that, then you're gonna go diagonally, right? And once you're done with that, then I want you to come up to the single leg step up, all right? Come up, try to balance yourself, 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, and then come back down, and then step up with your other leg, right? So just make sure when you come up, make sure you get your balance, 1-2-3, come back down, and then come up the other leg, all right? We're gonna do this is gonna be a circuit. You're gonna do one circuit. Once you're done with that first circuit, I'm gonna give you a 60 second rest, and then you're gonna do your second circuit. All right, okay. So you ready to go? All right, so now make sure you pump it up on this one, right? So just try to go as fast as you can, but just make sure you're under control. So you're gonna start off with your medicine ball. As soon as you're done with that, go into your proprioceptive plyometrics. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9. All right, it's 10. All right. And front and back. Okay, front to back. 1, 2, a little bit faster. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now side to side as fast as you can. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, and now diagonal. All right. 1, 2, 3, 4. You go ahead and look at 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right. You're gonna do your step ups. You're gonna do 10 on each side. Stable. All right. Once you get up to the top, I wanna make sure you gotta stabilize yourself. Count 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, and then come back down.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, and down. Left leg. 1, 2, 3. 1, 1, 2, 3. two, three. One, two, three, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. It's four. One, two, three. One, two, three. It's five. One, two, three. One, two, three for six. One, two. Oh. And stabilize. Repeat it. Repeat it. Go ahead and repeat it. One, two, three. One, two, three for seven. One, two, three. One, two, three, eight. One, two, three. One, two, three, nine. One, two, three. One, two, three for 10. All right, you got 60 seconds of rest, and then we're gonna start all over again.
Okay.
Back with the medicine ball throw. And so when you go through this next cycle, this next phase, what I want you to do is just try to bring your tempo up a little bit more.
Right? Okay.
So as soon as you slam down and pick it up, boom. Down, pick it up, boom. So just try to bring up your tempo.
Okay.
Same thing with your, I think you did pretty good with your plyometrics here. And again, try to stay under control, right? Once you know that you're under control, then you can try to speed it up as fast as you can, right? Same thing, right? All right. Make sure you're under control, because that's the most important thing.
All right.
So we got about, let's say 15 more seconds. Five more seconds. Three, two, one. All right, get it. Nice. That's four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten. All right. Front to back. One. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. And now side to side. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. All right, now diagonal. One, two, three, four. Just diagonal. Four. Seven, eight, nine, ten. All right. Now, when you do these step ups, now try to explode up. Hold the balance. One, two, three, and then down. Explode up. One, two. One, two, three. All right, for one. One, two, three. Explode up. One, two, three. Two. Drive that leg up. One, two, three. For one. One, two, three. For two. One, two, three. One, two, three. Three. One, two, three. One, two, three. For four. One, two, three. Try to control. One, two, three. For five. One, two, three. One, two, three for six. One, two, three. One, two, three for seven. One, two, three. One, two, three for eight. One, two, three. One, two, three for nine. One, two, three. One, two, three for 10.
All right, good job.
All right.
All right, next up we have the, we're going into our resistance portion of our routine. First up is got the bench press, and we're gonna superset that with a two-arm medicine ball chest press. So right now he's got three sets, 5 reps for the bench press, and then 3 sets and 10 reps for the medicine ball chest press, all right? So for the sake of time, we're only gonna run through one set, and then we'll go into our cool down. All right, so whenever you're ready. You got 5 reps. 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, go ahead and rack it. Next up is your medicine chest ball pass. You got 10 reps of this. All right, so you're in the camera right there?
Yep.
All right, cool. All right, so here we go. All right, so what I want you to do, make sure you got that 1 foot up in front. All right, so what we're gonna do, all right, I wanna make sure that when you're throwing this, right, it's gonna be up in here, and you're forcing it out, right? So now you're engaging that chest muscle, right? Yeah. All right, here we go. All right, so we got 10 of these. All right, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. All right, so now you've got a 2 minute rest. You're gonna take a 2 minute break, and then we're gonna go into the next set. All right, so we'll do 2 sets of this, and then we'll move on to the lats or the shoulders. All right. So another thing I want you to also consider too, when you are catching the medicine ball, right, you want to also work on the deceleration. So as it's coming back into you, right, try to grab it and decelerate with the ball, right? So that's going to also work out your eccentric phase of the workout, right? And then again, pushing it out, right? And when it's coming back in, try to catch but decelerate it at the same time. And that's called your eccentric or lowering or decelerate. All right, cool. So we got 10 seconds. Go ahead and get in your position. All right, go ahead and begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Go ahead and rack it. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Good job. All right. All right, next up, we have the lat pull down. Again, it's gonna be for five reps, and then that followed by the medicine ball throw. All right, so he's gonna go ahead and get started. So go ahead and get started. Three, 4, and 5. All right, now we're gonna go ahead and transition. We got 10 of these. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right. So now you take a 2 minute break. All right, we get into our second round of the lat pull downs for 5 reps. Go ahead and get it.
two, three, four, and five. All right, now we're gonna transition into the med ball pose.
Yeah.
It's about what?
It's a little harder now.
It's one. It's two.
Nice.
Three.
Four.
Five.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
10.
Good job.
Awesome.
All right, just for the interest of time, all right, we're going to move to our third resistance training, which will be dumbbell military overhead press. All right, next up, we have our seated dumbbell overhead press. We're going to do that for 5 reps, and then immediately doing a superset of the overhead medicine ball toss up. All right, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. All right, let's roll. Go ahead and drop the weights. And then we went over to our station. All right, so put your back up against the wall. Go ahead and lean just a little bit. Bring your feet out a little bit. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna toss the ball up. It's gonna hit the wall and then catch it. Remember, make sure you're doing your deceleration, right? So when the ball's coming back down, you wanna also decelerate it by controlling it, all right? Oh, wait. Oh.
Ready?
Sorry, okay, here we go. Three, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. All right. All right, next up, we've got barbell squats for 5 reps, followed by squat jumps for 10 reps, and then we'll have a 2-minute break and then repeat the cycle. All right, whenever you're ready, go ahead and knock it out. Make sure you have a nice little base. Good. And as you can see, he's going ass to grass. 3, 4, and 5. Go ahead and rack it. Now go ahead and go ahead and face me. Right. And make sure when you come down, nice and controlled. 3, 4, 5. If you need to, reach your hands over your head as well too. There you go. 6, 7, 8, 9. One more. Nice. Make sure you're nice and controlled. 10. Good job. All right. Ready for round 2? Boom. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Go ahead and rack it. Boom. Let's get those box jumps now. So 6, 7, 8,
9, and 10. Nice job.
All right.
So, normally, like I said, we would do 3 sets of the bench press, the dumbbell overhead squat, the lat pull downs, and the barbell squats, and then superset those power moves with it. So now we're gonna go into our cool down phase, and we'll be right back.
All right, so now we're back to do our cool down phase. Again, in the interest of time, he would do a 5-minute brisk walk on the treadmill, and then followed by static stretches of the calves, the lats, abductors, TFL, and a couple other things. All right, and the static stretches, basically we'll do them, and then we're gonna do them and hold for a 30-second count until we cycle through all the different muscles that we've worked out today. All right, cool, here we go. So first up is gonna be our calves, our gastrocnemius. So I've got a foam roller right here. So all I'm gonna require my client to do is to step in here, right? And plantar flex his foot and lean in so that he can get his calf stretched, and we're gonna hold that for a 30-second count. So go ahead.
Okay.
And start. So obviously we did a pretty much a whole body workout from head to toe. So in order for us to bring our heart rate back down during the cool down phase, part of the cool down phase requires you to do in some sort of either like a treadmill. In this case, for our routine, we've done a 5-minute treadmill walk to help bring down our heart rate, and then, like I said, followed by some static stretches. All right, go ahead and switch over to your next foot. And what you want to do is you definitely want to make sure that you're feeling the tension in your gastrocnemius, or what the other muscles call it, it's a soleus, which is underneath the gastrocnemius. I want you to come down onto one knee, and I want you to raise your right hand, and I want you to lean to your right. Okay. So what you want to do is you're trying to open up all of this in here.
Okay.
All right. And you can do both sides also for about 30 seconds. And then go ahead and lean some more, as far over as you can.
Good.
All right, go ahead and switch. That right leg out, left arm up. Go ahead and let that right arm also hang down to your side and lean over as far as you can. Thank you.
Next, we're gonna do your lat stretch. So what I want you to do is I want you to get onto both of your knees here. And what you're gonna do is just gonna take this, the ball, and put your arm over it. And what I want you to do, I want you to drop your hips and just relax that arm on the ball and try to get a nice stretch in your latissimus dorsi, your lats. All right, and then you're gonna hold that also for 30 seconds. And then you're gonna switch over and you're gonna do the same thing. Once you got a comfortable position with your arm, make sure you drop your hips down and lean into it. And then once you're in a comfortable position, hold it for 30 seconds. All right. Go ahead and switch over to the other arm. Four, three, two, one. Thank you. All right, well, that's it for this training session. Thank you to my brother-in-law, who was actually on his way trying to get his pro card. So the dude's pretty lean, right? Check him out. But just based off the things that we did today, even he's told me that there's some things that he sees that would definitely benefit him in the future, especially some of those balancing exercises that we did. So, hey, I'm always here to help them out. All right, Nick.